think kendo is a method of learning about ourselves, learning about people's relationship and individuals through the practice of sword. And it is obviously a martial art based on the history and culture and tradition of the swordsmanship in Japan.
My definition of kendo is, I suppose, when you look at the word, it's the way of the sword. But for me, it's a fun way of working out, kind of, and learning about the past and kind of Japanese culture. So, I mean, that's why I enjoy it.
Kendo is its actual meaning is way of the sword, but in modern application, it's really controlling yourself through the application of fencing. And by that way, you learn to communicate with people and how people react to you, and how you should hold yourself and the way you hold yourself and how it interacts with people, what effect it has on people. I believe that doing something relatively simple but difficult, you're unable to hide any part of yourself and your real self comes out. So whenever I fence with someone, I can tell if they're aggressive or frightened, or I have a lot of doubt in their mind. And likewise, when I have doubt or fear in my mind, that my opponent sees it. And, shows me that I have this fear. So it's not just a way of, it's a sort of constructive criticism of yourself, a way of bettering yourself by learning how you communicate numbers.
so I know the difference between Japanese kendo and kendo in other countries. But I'm very happy to know that every people, foreigners, enjoy kendo, enjoy playing kendo, and try to understand kendo. And I don't think I'm understanding kendo, but I just want to say, like, kendo in outside Japan is more like sports. So please understand the concept of kendo, and it's not like sports, and it's more concentrate on mind.
Is a way of also getting beat, but it's a way of developing yourself and your mind.
That was what attracted me to it. It was a bit more physical, but as I've kind of progressed in kendo, it's not really all about that at all. It's more about training yourself and your mind in situations, not to be calm in situations. Have experience and knowledge of different techniques and just kind of bring all that together. And it's not really all about physicality, it's just more about more in your mind.
Definition of the kendo is kendo itself is a learning process. Just we try to be better than yesterday, and that is the only things we have to consider. I have to consider for each practice. Each practice should be meaningful to study myself and also to find out my weaknesses. Yes, that is my definition of kendo.
Undergo any light!
there's three parts kendō: kata, and practice, and shiai, and all interlink. And kata, there is no, you know what's going to happen, but you have to project your best self. And in practice, you learn to hone your skill, and you try to make it automatic so that when you're in shiai, it comes out automatically like that.